Sup punks, Jay here, and welcome to the next episode of the Academy Challenge. So, last week we managed to get hold of Squirtle and Chikorita. On Monday, I managed to get Sprigatito and ignore the notification, sorry. And luckily today, a mining outbreak showed up. So, we're going to work on mining first before we move on shield on. And if we move quick enough, we might still be able to spin the wheel. That's better. Let's start with spicy and bitter. I don't need to scroll, do I? I can't have nice things, can I? Like a camera that doesn't do that every 5 minutes. Sorry. There's a good chance I'm gonna have to reset this now, thanks to some of them falling out. Maybe not, actually. Yeah, I'm gonna be first hit. This is not a good location for this outbreak. So the sooner we find mine, the better. And the best case scenario for this would just be to walk in and out of the area to try and make him despawn. Again, it is not the best situation, but it's also the only situation. Come on, where are you? It's more annoying for the fact that Minun is a very bad Pokemon. And in any other circumstance apart from this challenge, I would never hunt for it. I'm guessing that's what makes it a challenge. I am doing my best. It really doesn't help when things keep spawning down that hill. Might as well let that ad play. Come on, I want a green mining. I hope that wasn't it. Can't lie, I was hoping that the thing would the outbreak would be a lot better than this. Just in case. You can never tell with Elekid. Yeah, none of them. Let me try something. There are a lot more miners showing up than before, but compared to other outbreaks, this is ridiculous. Come on. Where are you? For a minute, I thought that Magnemite was shiny then. Oh, come on, please. I felt bad leaving mine in last week. I want to get over and done with. That one nearly despawned before I could check. No. Come on, man. Okay, we've still got 20 minutes, I'll admit that, but... Are you? I don't think so. I'm not sure if it's because of the lighting, but it can sometimes look like they are shiny. I'm just checking under the idea of curiosity. I don't think it's the case, though. What if it's higher than that? Like, up there? It's directly above it. Son of a bitch. Yeah, this is a lot better now. Oh, I did not know. Bumming. Yeah, this is a lot better, this. I kind of feel a little bit silly now. I don't know why, but these Minun do look green in the distance. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Hello, Clouts, how you doing? Just going for our annoying little gym-free mouse. While we're here, actually, let me just check how the emotes are doing. Yeah, they look alright. Yeah, the main plan is just to try and get Minun sorted out as quick as we can. Then we can move on to Shield On. And then if we've got time, we can spin the wheel a bit for one more option to hunt. And frankly, I'm not sure if it's because I'm colorblind, but I am honestly struggling to determine whether one of these Minun is shiny or not from a distance. Like, that one in the middle looks like it's green, but when you get closer to it, it's blue. I'm not sure if that's the first signs of being colorblind. And I just bumped into it, I like the buzz. That one in the far distance looks a bit interesting. You see what I mean? It looked green over there. I am finding that so confused. But yeah, how was your day then? Just a random Electros all of a sudden. I do not know why I'm going this far out, but if anything, it's just to make sure that, well, all of the Minun that were already there have despawned. The more I can despawn, well, the more of a chance of it spawning. It's not rocket science, but obviously I keep making it sound like it is. I think the major problem I have at the moment is the fact that there are some that can show up at the bottom. And obviously when I'm up on that platform, I won't be able to see that. Nope. Nope. Let's try something again. Now they should respawn again. Not by much. Good lord. This honestly feels like one of the most annoying hunts I've been on yet. I know what the shiny looks like. I've got the best way of doing it at the moment. Yeah, it's just... Well, you're seeing what I'm seeing. What exactly do I need to do to succeed? Because frankly, what is happening right now is me not succeeding. It's just me sucking. None of them. Nine minutes to spare, Jesus Christ, it's gonna be one of those days, isn't it? Come on, please. Ooh. That poor guy gonna jump me then. Can things actually start spawning, please? That is your job, to spawn. Let's check that one in the middle first. Nope. Blue. Dang it! I shucked that one in the distance. That's blue again. Come on! They nearly despawned. Doesn't matter, they're still not shiny! Dang it! Come on, this is starting to push it now. That one looked close. What's that one in the far bit? No. No. Again. Bah! Nope. None of them. You look close, but nope. None of them. You look close. But once again, you are not. I am proclaiming bullshittery of the highest declare. I am honestly getting quite convinced I could be getting colorblind when it comes to green and blue. Come on, mates, come on. Bring out a green one. Green, please. Please. I beg you. Give me green mousy. None of them. At least I have a decent strategy about spawning loads of mining now. Because as you can see, this is spawning a good amount. So yeah, if heaven forbid I actually have to redo this again. Which I might. We have a plan, I really hope that wasn't it. Oh, come on, that looked like that would have been it. One minute to go. One minute. Please. Klaus, you're still there. Damn it. I am honestly a little bit peeved off about that. Just checking all of them quickly. Yeah, none of them. It's kind of scary to think that I was knocking out all the mining from below me, and it could have shown up then. not a good start, not a good start at all. Spawn, please. All right. I'll reset. Sorry about that. Feel really hot. Ugh. Sorry, it's just there's something weird going on with my audio. I'm still hearing it. Hang on, let me restart the emulator. I mean the capture card. Still hear it, yeah. Okay, let's give this a try then. Why is it so bright in Chargestone Cavern? Alright. Let's try this again, then. I'm sorry. It's only when I'm clicking in something on the switch menu. It's kind of getting annoying. Let me try something. Okay, this is pissing me off now. It's honestly pissing me off. Right. It does feel like a lot of things are going wrong today. Let's try the old-fashioned recipe. Come on. Please get this right first time. There. Sorry for the ad break, Clouds, if you're still there. My camera is not working again! I'm getting pissed off about this, seriously. Thank you. Now please, can we just get a mine in? Hang on. Sounds okay now. Got something to do with the OBS. Right. I think that's done it. Yeah, that sounds a lot better, that. Okay, let's actually get back into shiny hunting mining. And since this has taken more than 2 sandwiches, if we find it, we'll instantly move on to shield on. Because frankly, I'm sick and tired of looking for this mouse. Please. I'm not sure if it's because this one's really close to the crystal, but this one looks interesting. It was too close to the crystal. Please, I just want a shiny mining, then I'll leave everyone alone. Come on, where are you? Plusle's shiny is just a darker red, isn't it? Jesus Christ. Mine are not suicidal. And that's a Magneton. Please be nice to me. Please. Was it just me? Was that Elekid spewing out yellow lightning? I mean, not yellow, red lightning. Please, man, please. The mouse, I just want a green mouse. I am trying, folks. But as you can see, this game really rubs it in my face that it hates me. No. I don't know why I went down there for a bit, mainly because it's obvious that up here is the better way of looking for mining. Dang it. Oh, hello. You took your time, didn't you? That's not what I wanted. Like, that's literally, I did not want this. I was trying to cancel it. First one done. Now we can just focus on shield on. And hopefully if we get that done soon, we could get another shiny in. Alright. You go over here. Let's have a look at mine in summary as well. Of course. Okay. Let me see here. Now I just need to find the file that's got shield on here. There. Problemo. Solvo. Alright then. Let's actually make sure that Minun is in the bright box. Zoid. Honestly though, that has got to be, so far, the most annoying hunt we've done for the Academy Challenge so far, considering we had to wait weeks to actually find it. Yeah, we're gonna get nothing but Alolan Geodudes and Golems heading all the way up to that point where Shieldon spawns. Considering it's not even on the list, and that we've already got one. There's also Chinchou as well. Here we go. I was just curious. All right. Save. And now it's time for some bacon sandwiches.
Yummy.
I understand if people are busy, but I have to be honest, chat. And if anyone who does streaming, and I'm wondering if you know what I mean when I say this, but it can be pretty lonely. Again, I understand if people are busy, and I'm not shaming anyone. But right now, the silence sinks in, I'll say that. No.
Yummy.
Fuck me, I forgot to get stream raiders going. Major apologies. Alright, let the hunt for our second weighted hunt begin, being Shieldong. And luckily, for last time, we now know fully what a shiny Shieldong look- We know the difference now. I just had a James Drunk call up ambulance. Da 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 da. I heard a weird sound. It sounded like a Magnezone. But I don't think Magnezone spawns in the wild in the Blueberry Academy. I know it spawns somewhere in Paldea near the Great Crater, but I've never known for a Magnezone to spawn around here. Da 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 da. I'm sure we'll find it today. It's not exactly a hard shiny to miss. Then again, Neva was Sentra, so... It's more down to luck, isn't it? Don't ask me why, but I just wanted to just check that Haxorus just in case I was incredibly lucky and that Terra Haxorus was shiny. So yeah, there was big news today. A bunch of games have been revealed to be coming out soon. Mainly Nintendo based. Like, they're doing a remaster of Epic Mickey now, which I know a few people we know are excited about that. I don't know if I would ever do anything with Epic Mickey. I just don't know what I'd do with it, apart from play, obviously. But I've never known the mouse to be good with any games. But the really important thing for me was Grounded being announced. Not particularly about Grounded specifically, but more for the fact that it was part of a big press conference recently that said that Microsoft were willing to launch 4 of their exclusives onto PlayStation and Switch. And in that list, Grounded was there, but there was also games like Hi-Fi Rush, and more importantly, Sea of Thieves. And today, it has officially been confirmed by the Sea of Thieves Twitter account that Sea of Thieves is coming to PlayStation, and I am ecstatic over that. I have been wanting to play that game for ages since it launched. Just the idea of just commanding your own ship, your own pirate ship with your friends, it is such good stream material, and I'm hoping we can take well advantage of it. And not only that, I will honestly find it fun. I'm just hoping it's cross-platform. I think it's a really awkward point in time with gaming these days, because everyone wants games to be cross-platform, but there are some exceptions where they can't. Like, we can't put Mario on PlayStation. We can't put Halo on the Switch. So I'm not sure if, like, you look different. I think you are it. Hi. You look like a mini bobini. Wow, that is such a subtle difference compared to on the overlay. Considering the time constraints, we're going to have to skip the sandwich on this one as well. Metal Burst. It's basically a steel type version of Counter. Sorry about that. We shall catch the plate dinosaur boy. It looks like we got to spin the wheel. I'm crazy. Crazy? I was crazy once. They put me in a cushioned room full of rats. Damn you, Tori, you got that in my head now. Let's have a look at Shield On. I don't think it has a mark, but yeah. Whoa. Alright then. I was not expecting Shield On to have such a little change. I forgot to clip it again. Shit. I need to get better at clipping things. Especially when the mods aren't around. Alright then. Let's evolve Shieldon into a Bastiodon. Intriguing. Very intriguing. Alrighty. Block. I don't think so. I've heard that Bastiodon has some relevance in VGC these days. Mainly due to the fact that it's very good using the move Body Press. Either way, another job well done. 6, 12, 14 additions so far. Okay, save. Now, it is time for my favorite. It is time to spin the wheel. If it showed up. Wrong one. There you go. Okay, folks. Our next hunt will be... Yes! Oh, Lapras is an awesome one. Okay, Lapras. Let me work on that one. That one needs to stay there. This one can do. Tiny. It's a bit of a tight squeeze, but there we go. Alright, let's get driving. We got a Lapras to find. Might even reach my go-to quota for every stream tonight, if this goes well. Okay, major problem though. Lapras kind of shares the spawn with other water and ice types around the area of the polar biome. I'm just trying to think now. I think the ice type would be the better sandwich, because obviously that will ignore Oshawott's Piplups, that sort of stuff. We won't be able to find it by much. Like, we'll be able to find it by a decent amount, but not completely. Sorry, got a bit of an itch on my nose. I'm dreading the day we have to start doing mini-ore. It feels like it's a hunt that you can get wrong so easily. I do have a plan for when we do it, but... Alright, here we are. Save.
Now, ice types need cloth sticks. Easy enough.
Sweet and spicy. Let's put all the peppers down first, because obviously with these cloth sticks being basically cylinders, it's going to be hard to balance them. Balance the peppers on top of them. Ugh, I hate the squidgy. I hate the idea of eating crab. Crab looks so horrible. Let's have a look for the gentle sea, let's have a look for the gentle Nessie. But yeah, as I said, there's something up with that dugong. Never mind.
I am gonna be so cautious of these dugongs.
For the people who don't know, Dugong Shiny is shit for the fact that it doesn't have that much of a change to it. Obviously, we'd be looking for a purple Nessie. I didn't know that there was an outbreak. That's big. I'm sure my Samurott could help you. Yeah, that's right. I have a shiny Hisuian Samurott. It was so cool when I found it. It was even an alpha. Dive, die, oh! Say what you want about these, but how bad the game is. The extra detail of adding extra animations for what situation the Pokemon are in is clever. And yeah, I can't lie, this is luck. It's luck the fact that we have an Lapras outbreak. This is awesome. No going around it, this is awesome. I love shiny hunting for Lapras. Thing is, back in Sword and Shield, Lapras was meta, thanks to that Gigantamax form it had. Because arguably, it was the best Gigantamax form in the game, apart from Charizard and Colossal. Naturally, on its own, Lapras is extremely bulky. And the main gimmick behind Dynamaxing is it made it massive in bulk. It was like the perfect gimmick for Lapras. And the fact that its signature move basically set up Aurora Veil and did damage at the same time, it's massive. That's 30 Lapras down. Honestly, Lapras was one of the most fun Pokemon I've ever used in Gen 8 VGC. The important thing about this is I can't stay away from the trainer, because if I teleport back to him and the shiny spawns near where Samurott is, that's a problem. Because it despawns. I'm confident we're gonna find it here. This Samurott's doing work. This is actually working really well. As soon as we beat 60 Lapras, we'll just go around on Maridon again. There we are. Whoops. You know, I heard a story once on the internet where someone when he was younger, like, read the Pokédex entries on Lapras on the fact that it's, in lore-wise, an endangered species of Pokémon. So there was a point where he kept catching and releasing Laprases to try and help with it. It was so, heartwarming to hear that. I think the best part about the fact that we're doing Lapras is, one, it's big, so it's gonna be hard to miss, and two, the color is noticeable, and three, there's a lot of them. Alright, I'll do the rest from here. Honestly, though, Lapras is one of my favorite Gen 1 Pokemon. I've obviously got to check the dugong just in case. Luckily, it's not shining. I don't know what I'm going to do when it comes to shiny hunting for seal and dugong though. Whoops. Ah, Lapras is so cute. And elegant as well. I think another word to describe Lapras would be an elegant design. Surprisingly, I've been able to claw back this stream, haven't I? It started off really poor earlier, but now, look at me. I got two shinies in a matter of 20 minutes. And now I'm hunting for one of my favorite Pokemon in this challenge. None of them are shiny. Aw, it's a really tiny one. It's like that one Ash got in the anime. Like, that one was known to be really tiny. I'm just checking, just in case. Remember what happened on the first episode of the Indigo Disc? That bear tick could be a problem as well if that keeps spawning. Full on 90 minutes, we've got plenty of time for this. And this is arguably the best odds in the game when it comes to shiny hunting, because as well as it being a sandwich, it's also an outbreak. But it appears that there's a tentacle somewhere. Thing is, when I was going through the the Indigo Disc DLC in the stream, I used a Lapras and I named it Melody. It really did help. Come on. I don't know why I'm saying come on, I'm loving this. It's a bit laggy. I'm not sure why though. Whoops. Bow, 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 bow. Bow, bow. I don't know why they would, but thinking about it, if they somehow gave Lapras an evolution, it would use the Eviolite in a crazy way. It would be crazily defensive. Ooh, Stream Rages is ready, but I don't think anyone added anything. If anything, that will use Stream Rages to end off. Oh, I'm surrounded by Lapras. But that is not a bad thing, because Lapras is awesome! But yeah, honestly, this is weirdly laggy. Six units? Someone actually put something down? Wow. I ain't arguing, because it did seem like the level we started on, it is classed as hard, so. Whoa, I nearly bumped into them too. There's no sound effect for, well, Maridon going. Now it is. Just out of curiosity of what other outbreaks there are. Sourcebuck, Graveler. We've been through mining. Come on. You know you wanna. I'll give you a good home. Please. I kept hearing tentacool there. There were a lot of tentacles. <laughs> 13 minutes, okay. And yeah, Lapras. Lapras, Lapras, Lapras. Pardon. None of you are what I'm looking for. Come on. I know you're out there. You have very good chances of spawning right now. Just a random Porygon. It's gotta be here somewhere. I gotta stop saying that. I keep repeating myself. Where are you? I know you'll find my company appealing. Series of words that usually entices Laprases to come in to my aid, particularly purple ones. I just wrote about something. Lapras has Parish Song, doesn't it? That's why I did that, I didn't know. Apologies. 8 minutes, come on. Come on. I know you're here somewhere. Come on out. I'll give you a cool nickname. Nope. You're not it. I'm just checking. Nope. I'm determined to get this tonight. Mainly for the fact that, let's face it, this is gonna be the best luck. These are gonna be the best odds I'm gonna have for finding Lapras in a while. I need to keep looking behind, but I'm not sure if my eyes were playing with me there. I just saw a tint of purple in my eye. Jesus. Where have all my pictures been going? Why are they down here? Right, hang on then. If Okay, yeah, I was wrong. Apologies. Wait a minute. Dang it. Come on. You kind of couldn't sure here. Frankly, for the record, I think I might keep this hunt going even after the sandwich. Because, obviously due to time constraints, I won't have enough time for another sandwich, but I still want to keep looking for Lapras. Damn it. Me bumping into them doesn't help. Under 2 minutes to go. Yeah. Scrap. Okay, I have suspicions about green and blue, but now I'm starting to get suspicions about blue and purple. Because that's the second time, though, I thought I saw a bit of purple. Let's see if we can get some last minute spawns going. I mean, last second spawn, so obviously there's no more minutes, there's only seconds. Oh, God, the... Yeah, that's it. Okay, we'll keep going, but obviously that means as of now, the odds are lower. And frankly, this blizzard isn't helping. Come on. See all those Lapras's, and then I think to myself, how did I not get one to be shiny under that sandwich's effect? Honestly, this blizzard's pissing me off. It's lagging this game to a crawl, and it's annoying. See? It just... I wouldn't be surprised if that nearly crashed the game. Oh, come on! This stupid blizzard's really annoying. I'm sorry if I'm a bit quiet. I'm just trying to keep an eye out, that's all. How long is it going to take for this stupid blizzard to go? Oh, fantastic. Rain on one side, blizzard on the other. Whatever way I'm on in this particular part of the Blueberry Academy, it's a lag-inducing weather effect. Ugh. Right. I've made a decision. I'm going to make another sandwich. I am convinced we can do this. There, you can't complain. Let's make this sandwich. I'm convinced we can do this. I was just unlucky. Extremely unlucky. Better. At least I can see where all the fuss is about. When the sandwich ends, the stream will then end. It's gonna show up as soon as I go down there, isn't it? At least the blizzard's ended. This looks so smoother compared to what happened with the blizzard earlier. Okay. Dare I say, I think we might have a decent strategy. And when I say strategy, I mean the fact that I'm gliding like this. And it's making it easier for me to spawn and despawn Lapras. Like that one over there, yes! Oh, it's a really tiny one. Okay. Let's be careful about this. Oh God. Okay, let's try a dive ball. Oh, thank God. Oh, damn. Shiny Lapras is in the bag. Let's see what's happening with this Lapras. Shell armor, good, good. It's a tiny one though, so I'm wondering, is it small enough to have that special mark? Okay. We've done good. We have done good. Right, next course of action. We're gonna go to Mesogoza and have this Lapras size checked. If it's the smallest Lapras size it can be, it'll have a special mark. And that'll be a definite win in my books. Because those ones are kind of rare. We'll have a shot. wondering if there's anything to have a quick scope around. Ah, Dragonite. Obviously, I'll admit there have been a few sandwiches that we've kind of wasted today, but I'll deal with it. Another job well done. Alright. Oof. That Paris song was a bit of a scare. 9, 6, 15. Nice. Alright then. Well, that's all the time we got for today, tonight, guys. Major scores today. We got Mining, we got Shield on, and now we got Lapras. Really good hunts today. Our next stream will be the last episode of Gotta Go Fast Feb, and that will involve a special treat we've got involving the murder of Sonic the Hedgehog. And yeah, we've pulled a few strings to try and make it so it's a bit more of an interactive thing, a bit like what we've done with Monster Camp. So hopefully that'll do well. And then when it comes to next week, obviously we'll be continuing that hunt for Quaxly if nothing can work out for Multi-Monday. We've got Pokemon Day next week as well. Expect a stream there. And also, yeah, we'll just continue more with the challenge. We're getting there bit by bit. I will eventually do it. So now... So, thank you all for watching. Sorry about all the hiccups today, but hey, I'm guessing some streams have this every day, so... Alright, for now, I'll see you all next time. On YouTube, if you guys liked the video, please sure to consider liking and subscribing. Everything else, you know, like, commenting on your best bits, or liking the video, blah blah. But yeah, I'll see you all next time. Until then, see ya.